Hello everybody. I'm delighted to share with you Orange 5G experience here because Barcelona is one of the three cities where we just launched this month a 5G SA, brand new 5G core up running now in Spain, and it's the first country in the group, so a very important milestone for the whole team. Where we are in Orange, I start by this. Where we are with the 5G, let's say, story. We started 5G in 2019. Of course, it's NSA, so we've still the 4G core network. Romania was the first country in the group, quickly followed by France, by Spain, the rest of Europe. And in last November, 5G also reached Africa. You know that we have a large footprint in Africa and MEA region. And so we are happy to launch 5G in Botswana in November last year. And more will come in Africa this year with more 5G launching. So 5G is also popping up on the African continent. And as I was mentioning in my introduction, the breakthrough we did is 5G SA, so to deploy the new core network, new SDM, subscriber data management, new signaling. The whole 5G SA chain is up and running in Spain and will be followed in 23-24 by our other geography in Europe. It's really based on local market condition that we decide to launch this quarter, this month, 5G SA, so more announcements will come on this later this year. As you know, one of the key points of 5G, there are so many capabilities it brings. It's really crucial that the whole industry, I would say the whole world, is able to touch 5G and influence and use it. So to be able to do this in practice, what we have implemented is some 5G labs that are really places where you have 5G SA up and running. Everybody can join. We've got some public administration authority, some big company, some startups, of course. A lot of startups come with their application saying, I want to see how 5G can boost my application in terms of video, in terms of everything. So it's really something that works. You can see by the number, more than 2,000 companies were accompanied thanks to this. We are already at almost 200 running projects. Just one illustration, you can see the area, so it can touch B2C with entertainment, but a lot, of course, is on B2B with a smart city, with Industry 4.0. And last but not least, e-health. Maybe one example in the Industry 4.0. If you have time to visit Orange Booth, you will see a demo of with the famous robot dog done by a company. And together with this company, we made an application of technician visiting a place that cannot be accessible by human or that is too far. And the technician with a helmet is fully controlling what the dog is doing, seeing, activating, and so on. So that's just one illustration, but it really shows that everybody, all industry, has to put their hands on 5G. We, as operator, will not do it. It has to be done and by everybody, so that really we explore the whole possibilities of it. So this is... I am presented what we see at the menu of the restaurant, let's say the 5G offer. Now let's move back in the kitchen to see a bit what's going on, let's say, in the background. Maybe you don't realize it, but as in charge of technical team, core network in Orange Innovation, all this implementation of 5G SA is done together with a complete way to manage networks. Of course, maybe if there are IT colleagues in the room, they will say, okay, cloud native, we do it for years, it's easy. When you apply it to a huge machine like the core network, 5G core, SDM, subscriber data management, is not as easy. And so we try to summarize this disruption that are coming together with 5G. The first one is disaggregation. Network is becoming software. One example is Open RAN. You have probably heard about it. We announced at the Mobile World Congress that we will test Open RAN together with Vodafone in Romania. It's a RAN sharing network. So it's one example where you can pick different pieces with different partners. So it's this disaggregation. The second part is virtualization. I guess most of you are familiar with it. So software and moving as much as possible to commoditize the hardware. To be honest, we are at the beginning of this journey. When it comes to RAN, you have to emit some signal to have some, let's say, physical things at the end of the day. So RAN will be commoditized probably later than the core network, but in core, we can put a lot of network function on, let's say, standard servers. The next one is automation, and it's really crucial because of all this complex and ever-growing feature of 5G. We need to continuously test and upgrade our network much more often than we were doing. We used to upgrade once a year, and now we would like to implement a CI/CD approach. We tested it significantly on signaling. So this is going. And why we do all this? Because we want to have, let's say, the customer, B2B, B2C, having the hand of on our network, a network as a service offer, so on demand using API. So we do all this transformation so that the network become available as a service. Our vision in Orange is that 5G advanced feature will be first used in industry. And here our vision strategy is to leverage as much as possible on our main core network. But this is not available yet. What we do today is point number one, that is to provide to a company all in a box, core plus RAN, or core only if you are using the public radio network. And then thanks to 5G managing slicing, we will be able to use what is called local breakout. So leverage on the core network, and then virtual mobile private network. So even the smaller company can benefit from the same differentiated QoS slicing and so on. Also, one challenge we have as large operator is we have legacy 2G, 3G, 4G, 5G. What we did in Orange Innovation is to say, let's imagine we start from scratch what it happened. So it's our flagship project called PKO, where we develop a 5G standalone cloud native network from scratch. We have it on a classical infrastructure. We ported it also on Amazon Cloud, and both are working perfectly. And we Amazon announced a partnership with some operators, including Orange, on a mobile private network offer, leveraging on this. Slicing will enable all this, but slicing, it will be a long story. Today, we will be able, by the end of the year, to manage maybe two slices, one general, one industry. And it's only in 2 years we think that we'll be able to manage dynamic slicing end-to-end completely in the network. So slicing, it's a long journey. We are only at the beginning. What comes next? Plenty of things are coming next. One of the messages is to say all that explained about this network continuously evolving is a bit the 5G story. I would say for us, there is not 5G A, 5G B, 5G Advanced, and so on. It's really a continuous rollout of new innovation. I just show here what's coming next in the standards. I mentioned example on extended reality. Maybe one point also on the IoT world, 5G will be able to accommodate basic sensor, ambient power IoT. It's really something green to be able to use devices that will just feed energy from the air. They will not consume any electricity, so it's one very promising area. Network power savings. As you know, Orange has a goal to be net carbon neutral by 2040, and we need the 5G network to be really exemplary on this low energy consumption. So to summarize, 5G is a journey. There will not be a revolution, 5G classical, 5G advanced. It's really a continuous rollout of innovation that will flow to the whole industry. Thank you very much.